A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th March, on the front page you have COVID-19 cases hit 82, second patient dies. So 68-year-old woman succumbed in Delhi, and now several states have started taking containment efforts as number of cases in the country are also rising. IPL has been postponed, one-day internationals, ODIs have been cancelled by BCCI. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called for a video conference of SAARC leaders to discuss a common strategy to tackle coronavirus, COVID-19. So all leaders of the grouping except Pakistan have welcomed the suggestion. And here you can see Farooq Abdullah, who had been detained and under house arrest since August 5, 2019, when Jammu and Kashmir's special status was revoked, has now been set free after 7 months of detention. He was earlier under house arrest, then was under under arrest in a guest house as such, which was converted into a prison as such, you can say. So you can see XCM also seeks release of other Jammu and Kashmir leaders which are still under detention. His detention under stringent Public Safety Act has now been revoked. Other former chief ministers who are still under detention are Umar Abdullah, Mehbooba Mufti. Then below you have Delhi government bans sports events till further orders. As we discussed above, also BCCI has banned events. So Delhi government has also announced this, and Delhi Assembly has passed a resolution against NPR and NRC. So it says if the center insists, NPR exercise should be carried out in 2010 format, but NRC would not be conducted. Then this is regarding MP crisis. So these news will continue, but we'll see the final news and cover that. And this is UP clears ordinance for recovery of damages. So we saw Allahabad High Court gave a ruling which was appealed by UP government in Supreme Court that the posters, you can see the hoardings which have been put up of those accused of violence during anti-CA protests in December 2019. They have been asked to pay compensation, but then they are still accused. The cases have not been proved against them. And Allahabad High Court asked UP government to bring down those hoardings. Even Supreme Court said we'll hear the case, but it has not stayed the order of Allahabad High Court. And now UP government has promulgated an ordinance. So you can see, this is how it is trying to avoid judicial ruling. So this is an ordinance called UP Recovery of Damage to Public and Private Property Ordinance 2020. So recovery notices were issued by UP government to at least 500 persons in the state for damage to property during the protests in December 2019. So ordinance would arrange for recovery of damage. And this is Pehlu Khan case, minor convicts sent to special home. So this is the mob lynching case in which Pehlu Khan, a 55-year-old dairy farmer from Haryana's Nuh district, he and his two sons and a few others were waylaid by self-styled cow vigilance near Bhairor on Jaipur-Delhi National Highway in April 2017 and were thrashed on suspicion that they were smuggling cows for slaughter. So Pehlu Khan succumbed to his injuries 2 days later in hospital. So this incident which happened in Alwar, the accused as such, there are two minors who have been convicted in the murder of Pehlu Khan. So Juvenile Justice Board is hearing the case, and they have been sent to a special home for 3 years. Means that is their sentence. On page 5 you have rain, hailstorm flattened wheat crop in Punjab. So untimely widespread rain accompanied by hailstorm and strong winds have flattened wheat crops over 1 lakh hectares in Punjab, with Fazlika district being the worst hit. So this rains which took place on 11th and 12th March have resulted in crop losses. There's a terminology used here, you can see lodging. Lodging has taken place on 1,06,950 hectares at different places in the state because of rain, hailstorm and strong winds. So this term lodging refers to crops falling flat on the ground. This causes yield loss. On page 9, you have Sengar, six others get 10 years jail. So, special court has sentenced expelled Uttar Pradesh BJP MLA Kuldeep Singh Sengar and six others to 10 years imprisonment in two cases linked to death of Unnao rape victim's father in 2018. So, Sengar and his brother have also been directed to pay 10 lakh each as compensation to the family of the deceased. In December 2019, he has already been sentenced to life imprisonment for raping the girl in 2017. And below you have, Centre announces common eligibility tests. So now, applicants for jobs in railways, bank and lower levels of central government will now write a common eligibility test, CET, from 2021. So this is what Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions has announced. So it is streamlining the hiring process for government agencies as well as the 2.5 crore candidates who apply each year. So an autonomous national recruitment agency will be set up which will conduct this online test under which candidates can apply through a common registration portal. So CET will replace the first level tests conducted by SSE, Staff Selection Commission, RRB, Railway Recruitment Board and IBPS, Institute of Banking Personnel and Personnel Selection. So this is a national recruitment agency is being set up. So the proposal has to be cleared by the cabinet. On the editorial page, the first editorial is People Over Profit. So this is regarding how commercial interests should not be allowed to override efforts to deal with the pandemic. So sports have been cancelled. So these commercial interests, cinema halls have been shut down. Schools have been shut down. So commercial interests said should not be allowed to override efforts which are being taken to ensure that the coronavirus does not spread. So, the pandemic which has been declared by World Health Organization needs effective response. And below you have dominion over territory. So, this is regarding ruling of the Madras High Court on respective roles of elected regime in Puducherry and the administrator, the lieutenant governor appointed by the president, that is Kiran Bedi. So, this verdict shows both potential for conflict and its resolution lie in the constitutional scheme. So the constitution already speaks of it. It was also pointed out how the elected governments or the legislatures in states are under the constitution, established under the constitution, but in the union territory of Puducherry, it is under Union Territories Act. So what are the powers and how the two should work in coordination rather than against each other has been highlighted by the court. And here you have the lead article, The Ambit and the Limits of Diaspora Diplomacy. So this is regarding Indian migrants abroad. So there are Indian migrants abroad and it is necessary for India, central government in India, to look at the political choices of these migrants through a more realistic lens. So this is in the context of joint rallies by US President Donald Trump and Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which took place recently in Ahmedabad and earlier in Houston. So in USA, so in that context, you know how India, which is the world's which has the world's largest diaspora and receives the highest remittances from Indians living abroad, so the diaspora often seen as more successful and more influential too. So these joint rallies assume significance in that context. And this is Temples of Critical Thinking and Debate. So this is regarding Indian universities. It says for them to be among the world best, they must be freed from excessive interference and politicization. So China example is also highlighted how, you know, a muscular push from the government of China with massive state funding has propelled Chinese universities into the top tiers in barely two decades. And you can say, it says all the great universities of the world are ideologically pluralistic with a mix of right, left and center among the faculties and students. There is no institutional line or official position on any issue. Then on Saturdays on op-ed page, you have this ground zero coverage. So this is regarding Jammu and Kashmir. It says back to school jitters in the valley. So in Kashmir Valley, after 7 month break caused by abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir and shutdown in the valley, students are now returning to school. So they struggle to catch up before school closes again because of the coronavirus threat to now. On page 12, you have this detailed coverage on PM calls for SAARC video conference and COVID, which we saw on front page. And this is Rajya Sabha nod for Vivad Se Vishwas bill. So this is the bill of 2020, which will give taxpayers a chance to settle tax disputes by paying their dues without any interest or penalty till 31st March 2020. Means they have to accept that they have not paid the dues and they have to pay, not going for litigation. So this is the bill. It has now been passed by Rajya Sabha. Then on page 13, you have Delhi riots. Shah ducks MP's queries on police brutality. So there were demands being made that discussions should take place on Delhi riots, because of which there was ruckus in the parliament too. And when the debate took place, two questions were raised on hate speeches by BJP leaders. The questions were ignored. So the Home Minister Amit Shah's reply during the debate in Rajya Sabha on Delhi riots is given here. Then on international page, you have virus spreads across globe, toll crosses 5,000. So number of affected is increasing, steps being taken globally is discussed here. You can see the death toll in China, Italy and Iran shown. And this is again, we'll see when this decision is taken. It is said the US President Trump is likely to declare national emergency, invoking Stafford Act. So it's a law, Stafford Act, which empowers the Federal Emergency Management Agency to assist state and local governments during natural catastrophes and coordinate the nation's response. And this is Europe now epicenter of pandemic, says World Health Organization. So this has also been declared. And this is hundreds take part in pro-democracy march. So these are pro-democracy protests going on in Bangkok in Thailand. And this is, you can see Thailand government is an army-aligned government. So first street protests are taking place after several years now. And this is civilian among six dead in US strike on Iraq. So Pentagon says it has retaliated for the rocket attack that killed three soldiers. But in this retaliatory attack, a civilian has also been killed in Iraq. Then on business page, you have continuation of the same news, like how the stocks have been faring regarding Yes Bank and regarding RPI intervention, which we already covered yesterday. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.